glad you're paying attention then. Yeah.
Here we've got boulder rubble, a little bit of landfill, I think, there, not very different than the shore zone. A little bit of sand creeping in here, a bit of lower energy. As we come up here, our wave exposure is dropping.
Yeah, we should look for the boulder barricades up here, too. Yeah.
Actually, no, our starting point was officially, I was never really filming over this side until we jumped over from Valdez, so.
This is near shore eelgrass subtidally. It's all encrusted. There's a lot of eelgrass.
You can slide over there and I can shoot this thing.
Incredible pattern of the boulders.
Definitely
on the beach there.
Sorted boulders.
Oh, and look at that soft beds
here.
Wow. Oh, I know. The
and
patterns
funny lineation
are caused
to the
by the
boulders
bedrock.
Here, but I think it's all bedrock strata looking down.
We're back
the
into the shallow current dominated
channel
that's
areas.
Here is just this streaming in the current. It's
a lot of development in this lowland in here on this part of Gabriola Island.
That is
sand beach over the rock platform.
Along the shore.
There's some dead forms in there, look very soft. Little puddles on top of those dead forms. This is a boat launching area.
Bare beach roof here. Nearest is in the channel. Pebble
veneer over sand.
Oh, beautiful ripple
then
pattern.
We've got a wide platform here of pebble sand. This is a current-dominated platform. Lots of bed forms
really
on this platform.
It
looks like an incredibly rich area for shellfish. Pebble veneer over sand.
Ripple patterns in the filamentous green. There's
a bedrock cliff. There's bedrock ramps.
Up
in the upper half, but then the lower two-thirds of the
inner
channel have us here. And we're looking into the subtidal here. Lots of bluegrass beds. There's a lineation of boulders here.
And brown
cats work or
lush bed.
Strata.
Patterns and boulders there.
Little groins with
some of the largest
on the southern side indicating a south to north set of transport.
Dikes and the layers in the sandstone.
As we come along here, we've got the
Zostra
hill and part of that, but it's not natural.
Bedrock here.
Looks like goat hill all the way along there.
Dominated by a filamentous green, the outer band is
near sand. That's a really sandy beach. Sand flat down below. Heavily sand beach, sand flat down below.
Brown diatoms. These patterns are just so weird.
Sand beach.
This is eelgrass all through here. Interesting shape of blocks. Eelgrass continuous here. And above it is mostly bare.
And here we've got a berm here of sand. About 5 meters wide, and then a sandy pebble beach face.
And
groin here.
Yes, there is eelgrass. I would say it's subtile here, though. Lots of filamentous green.
That's actually a runway behind us.
Diatoms. Oh. Oof. Diatoms.
Totally sort of shoreline with pebble.
Pebble
veneers over sand all the way along
incredible
here.
Steep block.
And we're looking ahead pretty much to where we started, back onto this beach section.
It's quite bare.
Interesting subtidal zonation
really,
of grass.
Really down into the near shore underwater.
And we've got a pebble veneer. Okay, you sure? Let's just go to this little point up ahead, the second one there. Yeah.
And
Okay, yeah, this is good.
Slope break there.
So we're done.
And there's the reds.
And
Nearshore subtitle reds.
I guess that's it.